Hello again, it's Alfie Carpenter here with another creative tutorial for Suffolk Libraries. Today's session is going to focus on something which is very important in a lot of artwork and especially in landscape paintings that I create with mixed media collage, and that is composition. It's a word which can cross over in the music and art world, meaning a general layout of a piece or the body of work itself. I'm going to show you how to make and use a viewfinder, which is an important and useful tool when creating our own compositions. For this activity, you will need your sketchbook, of course, or something to work onto. Some old scrap cardboard or thick card will also suffice. You will need some scissors, a ruler, and your pencil case or pens, pastels, paints, whatever you want to use to create your piece of work. We're going to use our viewfinders to create a series of different studies and sketches today, which will help us figure out interesting compositions and help us look at things in different ways. To make our viewfinder, take your cardboard or thick card and cut it into a square shape. Using a ruler and a pen, measure in from the corner of each side the same distance and then join up with the opposite side. You should be left with this kind of pattern. The central square is the one we need to cut out very carefully with our scissors, making sure that your hands aren't behind your scissors when they go through the card. Have a play around and see what other shapes you can use to create a window in your viewfinder. This is an activity I encourage you to try in your home or in your garden, or like I've done here when out for a walk sketching. The first thing to do is simply hold up the viewfinder and have a look through, playing around with moving it further and closer towards your face, noticing how the elements within the composition in the window change. Keep moving it around until you find a composition with which you're happy. Once you're happy with the composition you've selected, take a moment to really observe all the elements within the composition. Where do the lines fall? Whereabouts within the window do they enter and exit? How big and how small things are compared to each other? It sometimes helps to break down the elements of the composition into different sections. For instance, notice how the little yellow flowers in the foreground of this particular composition come up to about halfway. The next thing you need to do is draw the rough shape of your viewfinder's window into your sketchbook. For me, that was a circle. I then start to sketch out the composition, using the viewfinder as a window to look through and refer to as I'm sketching. You can experiment with using different viewfinders or focusing on different parts of the view. Do this until you can fill up lots of different windows within your sketchbook. As a landscape artist and someone that works a lot outdoors creating art, a viewfinder is a really useful tool, especially in scenes like this where it's really busy and there are lots of things going on. It can really help frame and focus in on a composition so you know which bits to concentrate on. If you can't get out for a walk, use your garden if you have one and see what interesting compositions and scenes you can create within the windows of your viewfinders. There's something really special about sketching or painting outdoors, so I really encourage you to do it if you can. It's a technique called plein air. If not, you can use the viewfinder in your own house, just pointing it around the room, picking out interesting compositions and then sketching them in your sketchbook. These can be very small portions of a room or quite large, depending on where you place your viewfinder.
Have a go at focusing on parts of a room which you hadn't really noticed or considered before or thought of as important. The results can be quite abstract. I challenge you to find 6 mini compositions within your house, garden, or on a walk using your viewfinder. I also encourage you to try and use different media with each little window composition that you make. So I'm using pens, pencils, collage, and different media. You might like to label or title each composition and note which media you've used.
So there we have it. I hope you found this exercise useful. You can then go on and develop any of these compositions that you like the look of into something bigger, into a larger piece, or take it further. And I hope it's helped you look at things in different ways, which for me is what art is all about. Have fun.